and good morning students, how are you? I hope you all are keeping well. Okay, keep it up, continue with the good health to study or to do any work you require. What first of all, good health. And most of the great people, when asked what will you demand from God, their first answer was this: good health. If health is good, you can carry out any other task. Okay, now coming back to your topic, we are doing the first lesson, The Portrait of a Lady. Now it's written by Khushwant Singh, a big name in Indian English. Okay, and he has written many other works. That's what I told yesterday. In this particular lesson, he has given us a pen portrayal of his grandmother. He has observed his grandmother for more than 20 years. Okay, when he got the understanding of the world, say at the age of 5, since then he has remembered many other things about his grandmother, and that's what he shares with us in this particular lesson. Yesterday we saw he has given us the description of grandmother, how she looked. She had grown terribly old, it seemed. He only confesses, Khushwant Singh admits, he confesses that for last 20 years he has observed his grandmother in the same condition. It seems that his growth has become stagnant now. Now years may pass, but no other changes can take place in her body, because in her body we can find wrinkles everywhere, on the face, on the skin, everywhere wrinkles. Now she has reached that limit of growth. So now she cannot grow any longer older. Okay, she has reached that level, and he has portrayed grandmother in a widowed form. Okay, she is already a widow since Khushwant Singh knows her. So yesterday we were also given the information about his grandfather. Only grandfather's photo was hanging on the mantelpiece, and grandfather was also looking very old, with his white beard covering the best part of his chest, and it seemed that he would not have children, but he would have lots and lots of grandchildren. That's what all I discussed with you. Then lastly he compared grandmother with the winter landscape in the mountain. That's what I told you, as in winter season mountains are covered with snow, so every that landscape, entire scenery looks white only. So similarly, that Khushwant Singh's grandmother is wearing what? White sari, because she is a widow, and she is moving in the house, hobbling about in the house, means moving in the house. So that way she also looks like a winter landscape. Okay, but she is very much peaceful and content. Okay, she has no regrets towards life, towards anybody. It seems that she has led her life very well. So now she has no regrets left. Okay, from there we are supposed to continue. I'll continue with the page number 4. Okay, second paragraph. My grandmother and I were good friends. My parents left me with her when they went to live in the city. Yesterday I told you, while giving the outline of this lesson, I told you that parents had gone to settle in the city. So Khushwant Singh at that time was a small boy, say of 5 years old, and then he was left with the grandmother. What was parents' idea? Ki once we settle down over there comfortably, then we will call grandmother and our son Khushwant Singh both. So initially they'll have to spend some time over there in the city. When they get settled, then only they'll call them. So till that time he was left with the grandmother in the village. Okay, and we were constantly together, because there was no other family member in the family. Only grandmother and Khushwant Singh were left. Now parents had gone. She used to wake me up in the morning and get me ready for school. So now he talks about his routine. The elder person in the family is now only grandmother. So grandmother has to look after the grandson. Grandmother would wake him up in the morning and get him ready for the school. She said her morning prayer in a monotonous sing-song while she bathed and dressed me, in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. So grandmother was doing it purposely. It was grandmother's job to get him ready, to give him a bath, to give him food, okay, and to dress him. So while she was doing all these works, what was she doing? She was saying that prayer in a sing-song way. She was in a way singing the prayer monotonously. Monotonously means continuously. Okay. So why she was doing this? Because she had the hope that if the same prayer is repeated in a song manner, then Khushwant Singh also would learn it by heart. As you see in the KG section, first standard, second standard, those rhymes are repeated again and again. So after some times, the children who are studying in nursery and KG, they also know those rhymes well. And the parents are very proud of it. He, our child, he knows this poem, that poem, so many poems he knows by heart. He doesn't require any book. So here, grandmother was also doing almost the same work. She was singing the prayer repeatedly with the hope that Khushwant Singh also would learn it by heart. I listened because I loved her voice, but never bothered to learn like most of the children. When study matter comes, hardly 10% students are ready to study. 90% would just like to shun it. Shun it means go away from it. Okay, so Khushwant Singh was listening to that prayer because he liked her voice. Otherwise, he never bothered to learn it by heart. Then she would fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk, a tiny earthen inkpot and a red pen, tie them all in a bundle and hand it to me. So all these works done by grandmother, slate, pen, inkpot. Remember students, these days we are writing with the ballpoint pen and ball pen, so many different types of ball pen. But in those days, I say till I was studying, we used to have that fountain pen. Fountain pen means we had to fill ink in that. So we had to carry the inkpot with us. So Khushwant Singh was before us. So he was also given that inkpot and a pen. So whenever the ink got over in the pen, again he would have to fill it with the ink. Okay. So that was the type of study. So grandmother was getting him ready with all these things, tying them in a bundle and giving him. After a breakfast of a thick stale chapati. Now observe their breakfast. What is there in the breakfast? A thick stale chapati. If you see city chapatis, city people's chapati, they are very thin, patli hoti hai. Barabar, tum 10 bar khao to bhi kya hai, pet bharega nahi. And city chapatis, the village chapatis, if you eat two, then also you may not be able to complete them. Do chapati bhi kha nahi paoge, kyunki wo moti hoti hai aur jaadi hoti hai. Okay, so here he would have the breakfast of a thick stale chapati with a little butter and sugar spread on it. So butter and sugar were easily available because they were living in a village. Then we went to school. She carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. So stale chapatis, you know, they are not special chapatis. They are the chapatis of the previous days. Stale. Basi bolte na, wo basi chapati. Basi roti ka wo nasta karte the. Aur baki ki bahut sari wo le jate the, grandmother. Kyun? Raaste mein jo kutte mile, kutto ko khilate the. Okay. My grandmother always went to school with me because the school was attached to that temple. To chota bachcha hai to usko kisi ko chhodne jana padega. Nowadays we have got van facility and other facility, but then van driver is responsible if something happens to the child on the way. Understood. So similarly, at that time Khushwant Singh was 5-6 years old, so grandmother would drop him to the school. Why? That was his responsibility. Second, the school was attached to the temple, both were very close. So one side children would be learning and one side the devotees would come to worship God. So it was easier for grandmother to spend the time, spend the hours, because again she will have to bring him back home. So jaake wapis jaake ghar jayegi, phir se aayegi, aisa nahi. Till Khushwant Singh studied in school, she would spend her time in the टेम्पल ओनली, रीडिंग द स्क्रिप्चर, स्क्रिप्चर यानी होली बुक्स है उसको स्क्रिप्चर बोलते हैं. ओके, द प्रीस्ट टॉट अस द अल्फाबेट एंड द मॉर्निंग प्रेयर. ये तो विलेज स्कूल में ये सब होता है. वाइल द चिल्ड्रन सेट इन द रोज ऑन आइदर साइड ऑफ द वरंडा सिंगिंग द अल्फाबेट और द प्रेयर इन अ कोरस. तो प्रेयर ऑल्सो दे वुड सिंग इन अ कोरस मीन्स इन ग्रुप. ओके, एंड अल्फाबेट ऑल्सो. माई ग्रैंड मदर सेट इन साइड रीडिंग द स्क्रिप्चर. जब बच्चे ये पढ़ते थे, अल्फाबेट गाते थे या तो प्रेयर गाते थे, तब ग्रैंड मदर क्या करती थी, अंदर मंदिर में बैठे बैठे स्क्रिप्चर पढ़ती थी. स्क्रिप्चर मीन्स होली बुक्स. वेन वी हैड बोथ फिनिश्ड, जब उनका भी खत्म हो जाए हमारा भी खत्म हो जाए, तब वी वुड वॉक बैक टूगेदर. नाउ वेयर आर दे गोइंग, गोइंग बैक होम. दे फॉलोड अस टू आवर, दिस टाइम द विलेज डॉग्स वुड मीट अस एट द टेम्पल डोर. तो डॉग्स दे हैव ऑल्सो फॉर्म द हैबिट, दे नो दैट फ्रॉम दिस लेडी वी आर गोइंग टू गेट चपाटीज. कुत्ते को एक दो दफा कुछ भी डालो तो वो फिर से तुम्हारे पास आएगा ही. ओके, सो ग्रैंड मदर वॉज गिविंग फॉर अ लॉन्ग लॉन्ग टाइम, सो डॉग्स ऑल्सो न्यू दैट फ्रॉम दिस लेडी वी आर गोइंग टू गेट समथिंग टू ईट. सो डॉग्स ऑल्सो वुड फॉलो देम टिल देयर होम. ओके, एट द टेम्पल डोर दे फॉलोड अस टू आवर होम ग्राउलिंग एंड फाइटिंग विथ ईच अदर फॉर द चपाटीज वी थ्रू टू देम. While they were following, what would grandmother and Kushwant Singh do? They would throw chapatis, steel chapatis at them, and the dogs would fight for those pieces of chapatis. Okay. When my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. Sent for means called. जब वो settle हो गए तो उन्होंने हम लोगों को बुला लिया, मुझे और मेरी grandmother को. That was a turning point in our friendship. So both were living together, so both were in a way there is that family relation of grandson and grandmother. They also have another relationship of friendship type relationship. Now the turning point came in their this relationship. Although we shared the same room, my grandmother no longer came to school with me. Earlier grandmother was constantly with Kushwant Singh only during the teaching hours, okay, school hours. He was studying in the school and grandmother was reading the scripture. Till that time only they were separated. Otherwise they were constantly together. Now in city what happened? Grandmother could not accompany him to school because now school van comes to pick him. So that detachment started. Okay, my grandmother no longer came to school with me. I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. There were no dogs in the streets and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. Now her favorite pastime of feeding dog, that also got over. So now what she would do? Now she started feeding the sparrows. Okay? ये स्पैरोस को खिलाना उसने शुरू किया. अभी डॉग्स को तो नहीं खिला सकते, इसलिए उसने स्पैरोस को, चिड़िया को, चिड़िया को खिलाना शुरू किया. ओके, स्पैरोस मीन्स चिड़िया. इन द कोर्टयार्ड ऑफ ऑफ द सिटी हाउस. ये सिटी हाउस उनका थोड़ा बड़ा था, आगे थोड़ा चौक जैसा था, कोर्टयार्ड यानी चौक था. तो वहाँ बैठे बैठे वो स्पैरोस को खिलाती. ओके, एज द ईयर्स रोल्ड बाय, एज द ईयर्स रोल्ड बाय मीन्स पास्ट. This is an idiom. So whatever idioms come in the lessons, I'll give you the meaning of that because there is a particular question about the idioms. Okay. We saw less of each other as the years passed. We saw less of each other. Earlier, they were constantly together, and that happens in every child's life, student. When the child is born, he passes the maximum time with mother. Then he gets somewhat more older. So he gets somewhat more older, then he identifies the other family members and gets along with them. Then once he learns walking, speaking, then he is sent to the KG nursery. There he meets other friends. So other people come into his life. So his detachment begins from the family members, from the mother. Then he grows older, then 5th, 6th standard. देन मोर फ्रेंड्स, स्टडी बोधरेशन, ट्यूशन में जाना है, स्कूल में जाना है. सो यू सी हाउ मच ऑफ हिज टाइम इज नाउ डाइवर्टेड, हाउ मच ऑफ हिज टाइम इज डिवाइडेड. एट द ग्रेटर एज इफ यू से 8th और 9th स्टैंडर्ड, 10th स्टैंडर्ड, देन द बोधरेशन ऑफ बोर्ड एग्जाम. सो मे बी फॉर सम स्टूडेंट्स ट्यूशन फॉर एवरी सब्जेक्ट. Some of like you go to the classes, you go to the school also. So your hours per day, 24 hours, are now subdivided into different activities. And your attachment when you were born, what was maximum with your parents, now that is getting reduced. Then you go in 12th standard, then more friends, some matured friends. Then you go to college. The college life is totally different. You just avoid your family members. You want your separate room. Okay? Because now family members are aside. Now friends are coming in our life, or girlfriends, boyfriends, whatever it is, they take place. We are occupied with them only. Okay? And then you complete your education, everything. Then the world of work. You have to go to job. You settle in life. You get married. And then again, same routine begins for your son. So, when you were born, that time, how much time you were spending with your parents? And after your marriage, how much time are you spending with your parents? So, you see, there is a vast difference. So, similar type of difference is taking place in Khushwant Singh's life. So, he tells us everything step by step. Ki, in city school, they got separated. Grandmother could not come to school because he was going by van. Okay? And she could not even feed the dogs, because dogs she was feeding while going to the school. Now she cannot come out of her house in the city. So she took to feeding sparrows, her favorite pastime. Okay. So then he was going to an English school, and here this change came. एज द ईयर्स रोल्ड बाय वी सॉ लेस ऑफ ईच अदर, क्योंकि इसको भी पढ़ाई का टेंशन है, इसको भी टफ सब्जेक्ट पढ़ने आते हैं, ट्यूशन में जाना होता है, होमवर्क करना होता है. तो जो पहले जो अटैचमेंट था ग्रैंड मदर के साथ, वो अभी धीरे धीरे कम हो गया. एंड ग्रैंड मदर ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड्स दैट थिंग वेरी वेल कि माई सन हैज़ टू बिकम समथिंग इन लाइफ. मेरे बच्चे को कुछ बनना है, बनने के लिए उसको स्टडी करना पड़ेगा, बनने के लिए उसको हार्डवर्क करना पड़ेगा, अच्छा रिजल्ट लाना पड़ेगा, अच्छी डिग्री पानी होगी. ओके? तब वो जाके कहीं अपने आप को स्थापित कर पाएगा. ओके? सो ग्रैंड मदर ऑल्सो नोज दैट फैक्ट. सो शी नेवर कंप्लेंड अबाउट दैट कि वाई आर यू नॉट टॉकिंग टू मी, वाई आर यू गोइंग अवे, वाई डोंट यू कम टू मी. सो शी ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड्स दैट फैक्ट. फॉर सम टाइम शी कंटिन्यू टू वेक मी अप एंड गेट मी रेडी फॉर स्कूल. सिटी में थोड़े टाइम तक तो इसने उसको उठाती ही रही, जैसे वो करती थी, उसको ड्रेसिंग भी करती थी. व्हेन आई केम बैक शी वुड आस्क मी व्हाट द टीचर हैड टॉट मी. नाउ शी वाज दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ पेरेंट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड स्टूडेंट्स. आई टेल यू, इफ यू आर सीरियसली स्टडिंग, दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ पेरेंट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड. मेनी टाइम्स इट्स माई एक्सपीरियंस दैट सम ऑफ द पेरेंट्स दे जस्ट पे द फीस, बस आवर जॉब इज ओवर. नो, दे हैव टू सी वेदर यू आर रियली स्टडिंग और नॉट, यू आर रियली लर्निंग समथिंग और नॉट, आर यू ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग बेटर रिजल्ट और नॉट. ऑल दीज थिंग्स द पेरेंट्स हैव टू सी. हियर ग्रैंड मदर वॉज कीपिंग अ फॉलो अप ऑफ वॉट एवर वॉज बींग टॉट टू खुशवंत सिंह इन द स्कूल. सो एवरी डे शी वुड आस्क, आज क्या सिखाया, आज क्या सिखाया. ओके? आई वुड टेल द इंग्लिश वर्ड्स एंड लिटल थिंग्स ऑफ वेस्टर्न science and learning. Okay? The law of gravity, arithmetic principles, Archimedes principles, the world being round, etc. ये जो भी सिखाते थे ये सब वो बोलता था, western science का बोलता था. Okay? This made her unhappy. ये सब इतनी नई नई चीजें पढ़ रहा है, पर इससे तो grandmother unhappy हो चुकी है. उसकी दो वजह है. क्या? एक तो वो खुद नहीं जानती, so she cannot help him in the homework. And secondly, what? She has the experience of Indian teaching only. Later on you will see. There was no teaching of God. सिटी की स्कूलों में गॉड के बारे में कोई टीचिंग होता ही नहीं था, और वहाँ तो मंदिर के बाजू में ही बैठते थे, तो गॉड की प्रेयर्स कितनी करवाए, कितनी गवाए, तो वो सब रेगुलर होता था. तो शी इज डिस्टर्ब बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, शी इज अनहैप्पी बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, एंड लेटर ऑन यू सी वॉट कम्स अप एंड शी बिकम्स वेरी मच अनहैप्पी. बराबर, शी कुड नॉट हेल्प मी विथ माई लेसन्स. शी डिड नॉट बिलीव इन द थिंग्स दे टॉट अस एट द इंग्लिश स्कूल एंड वॉज डिस्ट्रेस्ड, डिस्ट्रेसमेंट पेंड. स्कूल में जो सिखाते थे उसको वो अप्रूव नहीं करती थी. ओके, शी वॉज डिस्ट्रेस्ड दैट देयर वॉज नो टीचिंग अबाउट गॉड एंड द स्क्रिप्चर. ये अभी मैंने बताया वही लाइन है, सिटी के स्कूलों में गॉड के और स्क्रिप्चर के बारे में कुछ नहीं सिखाते थे. उससे वो पीड़ित थी, उससे वो दुखी थी. वन डे आई अनाउंस दैट वी आर गिवन बींग गिवन म्यूजिक लेसन्स. शी वॉज वेरी डिस्टर्ब्ड. वाई? बिकॉज टू हर म्यूजिक हैड ल्यूड एसोसिएशन. ल्यूड मीन्स वेरी इनडिसेंट. कि म्यूजिक उनके जमाने में क्या था, अभी म्यूजिक एक टैलेंट बन गया है, डांस एक टैलेंट बन गया है. बट इन देयर टाइम इफ एनीबडी सेंग अ सॉन्ग और एनीबडी डांस्ड, द सोसाइटी पीपल वुड डिसअप्रूव इट. बोले जेंटल पीपल जो है, सज्जन लोग हैं, वो ये सब गाना बजाना नहीं करेंगे. अभी के जमाने में वो टैलेंट हो गया है. दैट्स वाई यू सी इन द हिंदी मूवीज, ओल्ड मूवीज, हीरोज वुड हार्डली डांस. हीरो डांस करेंगे ही नहीं. क्यों? समाज उसको एक्सेप्ट नहीं करता था. समाज उसको क्या गिनता था, कि ये तो यार ये औरतों का काम है, ये बच्चे लड़के जेंट्स थोड़ी ऐसा करते हैं. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई ग्रैंड मदर वॉज अनहैप्पी. इट वॉज द मोनोपोली ऑफ आर्लॉट्स एंड बेगर्स. ये उसकी सोच थी कि ये गाना बजाना किसकी मोनोपोली है, गाना बजाने का काम कौन करते हैं. तो आर्लॉट्स यानी कॉल गर्ल्स और वो सब बोलते हैं ना, वो करते हैं ऐसा, या तो बेगर्स या तो भिखारी लोग करते हैं गाना बजाना. वो पुराने टाइम में मूवी में देखो तो वो कोठे के गाने आते हैं, तो वो कोठे में कौन गाता बजाता है, वो औरतें ही गाती है. ओके, तो इसलिए उसका एसोसिएशन इससे बहुत ये डिसेंट, इनडिसेंट एसोसिएशन है. इसलिए वो शी डिड नॉट अप्रूव एंड नॉट मेंट फॉर जेंटल फोक. वो बोलते थे सज्जनों के लिए ये काम नहीं है, सज्जन लोगों के लिए. शी सेड नथिंग बट हर साइलेंस मेंट डिसअप्रूवल. शी रेयरली टॉक टू मी आफ्टर दैट. ये जब पूछा, कहा कि हमको म्यूजिक सिखाया गया है, तो वो उसको अच्छा नहीं लगा. तो यहाँ उसके बाद उसने शायद ही उसको पूछा कि आज क्या पढ़ाया, वो क्या पढ़ाया, क्योंकि सिटीज एजुकेशन इज टोटली डिफरेंट टू विलेज एजुकेशन एंड ऑलमोस्ट अपोजिट टू हर बिलीफ्स. सो दैट्स वाई स्टूडेंट्स, शी डिड नॉट अप्रूव दिस. सो दिस क्वेश्चन कम्स कि वाई वॉज ग्रैंड मदर अनहैप्पी विथ सिटी एजुकेशन. सो ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स आर देयर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, शी कुड नॉट हेल्प इन होमवर्क. She did not know anything about science, Western science and all that. She could not accompany Khushwant Singh to school. And this music, there was no teaching about God and scripture. And music, she did not approve music because it had lewd association. So students, keep this, all these details for this particular question in mind. In my next video, we will see the lesson from here. Till then, you keep this, all the details in your mind. Stay fit, stay fine. Thank you.